Welcome back to Inside Southeastern Baseball with head coach JRT's, presented by your local Southern Quality Four Dealers. Champagne beverage as we tape right here from Benny's Place in downtown Hammond. And coach, not a whole lot to say about Sunday as Lamar came out and really swung the bats. They took the series, the first series that your club lost all season long. You got to bounce back from this one.
Oh, absolutely. You know, they did a great job. I mean, it's not much to say. They just took it to the woodshed. I mean, they swung the bats well. They pitched it aggressively. You know, they won the series. They did a good job.
Well, Coach, it's kind of strange ground that now at the midpoint of the season, that this is your first series loss. What's your message to your team moving forward now?
Well, it's about bouncing back. I mean, we lost one series, and you got to make sure you bounce back from it quickly. We get a good chance to get back on the field tomorrow. We get a good chance to get back this weekend, go on the road. Play a good old Roberts team over in Oklahoma, so we know it's going to be a challenge playing over there, but I think the guys are really eager to get back on the field.
Well, the Lions had a chance to host a very special event on Saturday as they hosted Alumni Day right there at Pat Canela Diamond. Here's the story.
This past Saturday, the Southeastern Alumni Association held Alumni Day at the ballpark. The annual event always draws a good crowd, and this year was no exception as baseball alums came back to campus to celebrate their glory days on the field.
Meeting all the people, meeting the players from other schools, taking the trips. I have people that I've known now for a long, long time, and some of them have passed away, and I miss them very much. So it was just a nice time to be a part of something that we did very well during those years, and I enjoyed it very much.
Meet Bob Hardy. Bob played baseball for the Lions from 1959 to 1962, and currently holds the Southeastern record for strikeouts in a career. Bob attends as many of these alumni events as he can, and Bob is amazed about how the campus has changed over the years.
The school only had about 1,700 students at the time. Now we're up, 15,000, something like that. It's just such a nice place.
Bob came to Southeastern to play baseball, but he ended up leaving with a degree and the love of his life that helped him improve in the classroom.
I was here and I played a lot of baseball. That was what I did a lot. I studied, but I still was thinking baseball almost all year round. Then I met Lydia and I became library bound because that's what she did.
She's very, very bright and has gone on to a really successful career. But what happened, as I said, the coaches found out that I was an English major, so lots of times, you know, they would just have us kind of help tutor.
While Bob and Lydia were at Southeastern, they became friends with Bob DeVinny. DeVinny played ball with Hardy and went on to become a major player in Jefferson Parish politics. In 2010, DeVinny died, but this past year, the idea was raised to start the Bob DeVinny Baseball Scholarship. And who stepped in to fund 100% of the remaining amount needed? That's right, Bob and Lydia Hardy.
The minute they established that, you know, at the time, we thought, well, that might be something that we want to do. And then when Cody said how much was remaining, we just felt like certainly something we could do.
The Hardys call Texas home now, but never miss the chance to keep up with the Lions, whether it be live in person or on the internet. As you can see, Alumni Day 2013 was a huge success both on and off the field. Former players got to catch up with each other along with the current players. And one lucky future Lion will be able to play ball at Southeastern due to the generosity of the Hardys and the memory of Mr. Bob DeVinny. Both Bob and Lydia are living examples of what it means to be a Lion for life.
Coach, a very special day on Saturday. Is any time you have alumni come back and be a part of Lion baseball, I know that's always special. We had a chance right there to interview a very special couple that gives a lot of money and gives a lot of support to Southeastern baseball.
You know, it was a great turnout. When you see so many guys come back like that, we preach to our players all the time about what it means to be a Lion and Lion for life. But when they see it really in action, these guys coming back and how much it means to them, then you see people like Mr. Bob and Ms. Lydia Hardy and the job they do and how generous they are to the program. They are a program. That's what this program is all about, is people like them.
Coach, we're now going to take a look at another Lion profile of the week. And this week we're going to take a look at, we talk about it every week because this is our host this year, is Benny's Place right here in downtown Hammond. But Mr. Benny Latina, here's the story.
No matter where you go in Hammond or South Louisiana, stop and ask someone about Benny's Place. And for sure they'll have a story to tell you about the oldest bar in Tangipahoa Parish.
It's been a gathering place for locals for as long as I can remember, and surely as long as a lot of people can remember.
Benny Latino III was 3 years old when his dad, Benny Latino Jr., bought Benny's Place in Hammond. In fact, before Benny's was Benny's, it was actually called Kelly's. But new owner Benny Jr. changed the name, and it's been that way for well over 40 years now. And now all those years later, Benny's place is an icon.
And I remember coming in here when he actually was buying the place, and it's been in our family ever since. Until about 2 years ago, when my brother-in-law Paul is running the day-to-day operations for my dad now. But my dad actually ran it day in and day out for right at 40 years, so 41 years. And
Latino Jr. is so loved by the people in this community, and you can tell that by the pictures on Benny's Place Facebook page. Yeah, that's right. Benny's Place is its own Facebook page.
My dad's touched a lot of people's lives, you know, and he's, as a result, you know, he had a stroke a few years ago, and as a result, people reached out to him, and he's really a staple of this community. You know, he's a guy that came up with nothing and made something for his life and for his family and for his kids and grandchildren.
Back in the day, Benny's used to be the home of some pretty good eats, including hamburgers and po' boys. The kitchen was staffed by Latino's mom, and she turned out that good food that Benny served. But now the place has stopped serving food, yet it still remains a mainstay among the locals.
My grandmother, Mary Latino, was tired of time for her to retire, so as a result, my dad just didn't see the need to keep the restaurant side open. It's been just strictly a bar ever since.
Inside Southeastern Baseball is filmed at Benny's each week. Sports, as well as Southeastern sports, have always been important to the family and Benny's place.
You know, it's been a frequent stop for a lot of the Southeastern coaches from way back when. You know, I can go back to Coach Brewer. And since then, it's been a continual baseball and football and basketball, to be honest with you.
Benny's Place is open 6 days a week, and while you may not find Big Benny behind the bar that much, you'll find Paul, Super Dave, and occasionally Little Benny. But if you stumble into Benny's on a rare night and find Big Benny behind the bar, consider yourself lucky, because you're being served by a local legend, the man who had the vision for Benny's Place many, many years ago.
I want to also take the opportunity to thank all the locals that we're here to support him through his trying times. Doing very well, as you know now, and he's come a long way, and we're proud of him, and I couldn't ask for a better father.
Obviously, Mr. Benny's generosity for allowing us to do our program here each and every week, but he does so much not only for Southeastern, but just the Hammond community.
You know, you saw Little Benny being interviewed there, you know, his father, this bar. There's so much history here in the bar alone. I mean, like you said, if these walls could talk, there's no telling what you'd hear. You know, but they're a staple of this community, and we really appreciate all they do for us.
All right, now time to take a look at our Tip of the Week with Coach JRT's.
Hi, welcome to this week's Tip of the Week. This week, we're going to demonstrate outfielders how to catch a ground ball as they're trying to prepare to throw a runner out. To help demonstrate that, we have junior outfielder from Albany, Louisiana, Gabe Woods. As you can see, Gabe getting prep position, preparing for the ball. Once it's thrown, he approaches it, his glove stays right outside his left foot, then he throws his right foot and it gets a good crow hop to make a strong throw. Let's watch it again. Glove next to his left foot, throws his right foot, so he get rid of the baseball with one strong step. That is this week's Tip of the Week.
Coach, we see Gabe Woods there fielding a ball in the outfield and showing us how to transition to a good, powerful throw.
Gabe does a great job demonstrating the fundamentals, setting the throw, getting a good power position to make a strong, accurate throw for the infield.
All right, well, let's take a break. When we come back, we're going to wrap it up here on Inside Southeastern Baseball with Head Coach JRT's, presented by your local Southern Quality Four Dealers and Champagne Beverages. We tape right here from Benny's Place in downtown Hammond. Stay with us.